Subsurface acidity in WA is widespread, and it covers about probably 11 million hectares, or roughly half of the wheat belt, and it's the acidity that occurs in the soil below 10 centimetres. The question of how much lime needs to be applied is an important one, and really can only be determined by soil testing. You need to know what the soil pH profile is in layers 0 to 10, 10 to 20 and 20 to 30 centimetres, and on sandy soils perhaps even deeper, take some samples from 30 to 40 and in some cases 40 to 50. You need to know how much and how deep that low soil pH is. When trying to develop a liming plan for your farm, what really needs to happen is look at which paddocks require the lime based on the soil testing, and then determine which ones are going to be best. So in the good performing paddocks are probably the ones that you need to look after. So they might be still in maintenance liming, so make sure that they don't become acidic and you don't start losing production. Usually the most acidic ones also have a range of other problems, and they probably shouldn't be the ones that you tackle first. Unless, of course, you've got everything else okay, and when you are tackling those ones, then some tillage or some mixing in of lime to get it down into the profile is probably important. Most lime is applied to the surface, is top dressed, and then just gradually gets moved in through the profile with the seeding. But with no till, we're seeing stratification of that lime on the surface. If the pH profile is low, or pH is low deeper in the soil, then some form of strategic tillage, actually mixing the lime into where it's required, and that's what our work is actually currently investigating. This year with GRDC funding, we have a range of field trials. We are looking at rates of lime, and we also have other soil ameliorants added in there to try and look at how we can best distribute the lime through the profile and compare that to lime being applied on the surface. So we have one-way plough treatments and different rates of lime. And we're coupling this with research that we're doing in conjunction with the University of Western Australia, and also here in Northam in the glasshouses, where we're looking at lime movement through columns, and we're looking at the reaction of roots to the different combinations of treatments. The benefits of this work to growers potentially is to try and make the lime that is applied react more efficiently and effectively in the soil, and therefore give a quicker return to growers from treating the soil constraint of acidity.